na yung food natin should always be considered as our medicine first and foremost. Kasi if you notice, we have a lot of grandparents who reached up to 95 years old. And yet, during their time, Sir the Fourth, wala pa silang masyadong access to medical technology, to specialty hospitalizations. They probably are not taking so much medicines. You know, a little bit of tapal-tapal ng mga dahon, maybe a little bit of pain reliever kapag hindi na nila matiis. But very seldom do they develop diabetes, hypertension, I believe even tumors, no? And a lot of them have 12 children without necessarily going to a hospital to deliver their babies. And they just die in their sleep at 95 to 100 years old. And that is what we are trying to recover. Right now, we see patients who are 60 at 65, nasa ICU na, needing interventions. And if we are going to lose 30 years of our life because of these poor habits, then maybe we should change as well. Next slide, please. So, ito ang unang-una natin dapat baguhin. Too much holidays, sabi nga nung first speaker natin. In too much holidays, we lead to too much drinking. And of course, this will lead to more fatigue. Ang holiday natin should be restful because there is a condition called the holiday heart syndrome. Next slide, please. Gaano daw ba karami ang tanong ni Sir the Fourth na dapat inumin, na pwedeng inumin, na alak? Wala po kasing walang standard for that. Iba't iba ang ating katawan. Para sa akin, umuwi ka na at matulog bago ka pa malasing. And that is my that is my ruling for myself. Hindi ko na kailangan nagpapaalam doon sa mga kainuman. As long as napagbigyan sila, then I think I should go already because I intend to take care of my heart as well. Next slide, please. Ano kasi ang mararamdaman natin when we have too much to drink already? Pagod tayo kinabukasan. We cannot work. Shortness of breath. Even chest pain, palpitation, and dizziness. And this is the holiday heart syndrome. Next slide, please. Okay, sa next slide, makikita natin, yung normal na puso natin at tibok, akala natin palpitation lang, but a lot of people develop fibrillation, totoong fibrillation. That means wala na sa tiyempo yung tibok ng kanilang puso. And the next slide will show us ano ang nangyayari. We have a lot of cases. In fact, nabalita nga mga sikat na mga tao who have been rushed to the hospital, nasa inuman sila, nagkaroon ng fibrillation, nauwi sa abnormality of the beating of the heart, and eventually led to their demise. Ayaw natin po yun. Next slide, please. So, drink moderately. How much alcohol can you drink at a safe level? Iiwanan ko naman ng slide na ito so that the guys as well as girls can take a look and memorize this. For men, 4 or 5 drinks per day, sobra na po yun. Okay? Next slide, please. Now, what do we do? If our heart, now this is an advice coming from our former health secretary who became a senator, nutritional supplementation. If you do not know what to take and you think that you have a weak heart, magnesium is one of those that you can take a look at. Ask your doctor about it. Ask your cardiologist about it. Very rarely do doctors prescribe it. Kasi ang piniprescribe ng mga doktor kung ano yung commercial ng mga vitamins and supplements that they see also on television na sinasabing kompleto na from A to Z. If one has a heart condition, one may need more magnesium than the usual. Okay, next slide, please. A study. 40 analysis studies were done. More than 1 million participants joined. They consumed 100 milligrams or more of magnesium each day. Nakita nila they reduced the risk of stroke and heart failure by 7% and 22% respectively. So some of you may be prescribed by your doctor some medications to prevent a heart attack like trimetazidine, like maybe carvedilol para sa puso at circulation natin. But why not consider also taking magnesium. Okay? Next slide, please. Of course, these are some of the foods that we will avoid. We should avoid. Tinalakay din ito by another speaker, no? Ang iwasan natin talaga comfort foods. As I mentioned, yung mga lolo natin nung araw, rarely do they eat chicken. Only during Sundays, I believe. I remember my own lola is saying, you want chicken? Hulihin mo yung manok. Otherwise, malunggay tayo. And that is a very good advice from an old lady. Next slide, please. Okay, these are some of the remedies that one can do if one is feeling some of those palpitation or kaya discomfort in their body, like ginger as a tea, lemon as a tea, green tea, and taking a lot of garlic, not raw, but with your food, has been shown as an old remedy to help people with those conditions. Now, another condition we'd like to tackle is the next one. Totoo ba ito? Can we go to the next slide? Totoo nga ba na may binabangungot? Totoo nga ba na ang binabangungot ay nauuwi sa atake sa puso? At may namamatay ba talaga sa bangungot? What is the most common reason para sa mga pagbabangungot na ito? Next slide will show us. Fault natin ito. Ang hilig na natin ngayon pumasok sa mga restaurant that will give us a whole line of food for 500 pesos. Ano nga ba tawag doon? Eat all you can. Ang tawag ng Korean doon, mukbang. Ang tawag natin doon, stuff your face. We like to do that. Let us avoid restaurants like that. Hindi sa kinakalaban ko sila, pero i-avoid din natin ang restaurants with which will give you unlimited rice. Dahil overstimulation can, next slide please, really damage and cause inflammation in the pancreas. Yung pancreas na yan, namamagayan. And next slide will show us, this can lead to a condition called pancreatitis. Inflammation of the pancreas can later on lead to another condition, hemorrhagic pancreatitis. Yung hemorrhagic pancreatitis, yun yung nangyayari sa binabangungot, kaya sila pumapanaw. Ayan, so, bakit? Dahil sobrang stimulated yung lapay or pancreas from the stimulation ng food na napili natin. So dapat, hindi na nga dapat nauuso yung dinner date. Para sa akin, mas maganda yung breakfast date. Yung sabay ba kayong magbe-breakfast? Alam mo na, before the breakfast. Next slide, please. Nangiti si Sir Lafort. Alam niya ibig sabihin nun. This is internal hemorrhage that can lead to death. And if we want to avoid that, the next slide will show us another supplement that will be good for us. Etong kulay pink na ito, studies have demonstrated that susceptibility to diabetes is influenced by zinc deficiency. Hindi lamang diabetes. This mineral participates in every step of the process, including insulin synthesis. Yung pagtunaw ng mga kinain natin na pansit, na inulam natin sa kanin, at nilagyan natin ng tinapay, at nag-dessert tayo ng ice cream. All of those are carbs that will cause inflammation in the pancreas, and zinc will be one good supplement na pwede nating ititake. Next slide, please. Okay, what can we take as well? No, kapag tayo ay nabusog ng husto sa gabi, and instead of taking coffee with it, sabi nga nung another doctor natin na baka mag-cause lang ng anxiety with us, try taking okra water, lemon water, or cucumber water. Because these three types of water na nilagyan ng mga gulay natin contains a lot of zinc that will help in digestion. Compare nga natin, if I'm sure a lot of you have been to Singapore, they don't take cola drinks or soft drinks together with their food. They take tea. Or they take this water with their vegetables. Okay? Next slide. Pupunta po tayo with another condition na problema ng marami, and that is how they can manage their creatinine. Mataas ang blood pressure, mataas ang sugar, which will lead to a problem in the kidney, which results in increase in creatinine level. Next slide, please. The next slide will show us yung hypertension would probably be due to a blockade in our arteries or probably a hormonal problem or probably stimulation, overstimulation of our sympathetics. So, yung pagtaas ng blood pressure natin can lead to a high creatinine level. But hindi lang dahil sa pagkain. Next slide, please. Yung stress natin, sobra rin. Mas marami tayong stress ngayon because we are so proud that we are doing multitasking. Akala natin, yung boss natin, proud na proud sa atin kasi multitasking tayo. Akala natin, porque umuwi tayo ng alas 7, alas 8 ng gabi, better kaysa dun sa umuwi ng alas 5 ng hapon. Pwedeng marami kang ma-accomplish, pero at the same time, pwedeng yung kandila natin umiikli at sinusunog natin in both ends. And what will happen when we get sick, when we are in ICU? Ang dadalaw lang naman sa atin, yung kamag-anak at pamilya natin, hindi naman tayo dadalawin. Kadalasan ha, ng katrabaho natin. So learn to manage our stress. Learn to manage our workload. So, next slide please. Ano ang ginagawa natin so that we will be able to monitor ourselves? Okay, nasa part 2 po siguro tayo, sir. Alright, ang next slide natin will show us a laboratory test. Okay, this is our diabetes mellitus. Okay, after hypertension, madali namang malaman kung may diabetes ka kahit wala kang symptoms. All you need to do is remember the PPP. Polydipsia, polyuria, polyphagia. Lagi kang gutom, lagi kang uhaw, lagi kang ihi ng ihi. More than the usual. And that could be a sign of sugar that is irritating your urinary bladder already. Kaya ka ginigising sa gabi. Next slide, please. And again, ang diabetes is not only a sugar problem. Nakita nila, it is also an autoimmune problem. That means our own body is attacking ourselves. And what happens? Why does it happen? Kasi again, ang dami nating stressors in our lives. Hindi lang mental, pati physical. So it's very important that we do our own testings. Nagpapalaboratorio tayo. Next slide, please. So ito yung creatinine. Ayan, titingnan natin ha kung tumataas na yan. Huwag nating ipapa-urinalysis lang ang ating katawan o ating sarili. Get a blood test. At huwag nating i-monitor yung sugar lang and cholesterol. Very important, I monitor din ang creatinine. Sabi nga nila, mas mahirap pa ang taong dinadialysis. Dahil it's a lifetime ng pahirap kaysa sa taong biglaan na lang, inatake sa puso at pumanaw na. Probably I agree with that. A lot of patients feel the same way. Next slide please. So, ano ang sintomas ng mataas ang ating creatinine? Nakalista dyan. We are dehydrated. Again, we are fatigued. We are weak. May palpitation tayo at mayroon tayong mental confusion. So, pwede nga ba talaga tayong makasurvive? Next slide please. Without dialysis? Well, check with your nephrologist. But there are people who were able to manage their creatinine level to go down para hindi na sila mauwi sa dialysis. These slides that I'm showing to you are some of my slides in my own YouTube channel. So after which, kung gusto ninyong makita yung mga advices na yon, you just follow yung name ko po. Ito yung ipapakita ko doon. Next slide. May mga pagkain bawal sa kidney. Unang-una na dyan, yung paborito nating soft drink. Ayan. So, if we can live, actually, kaya naman nating mabuhay without taking soft drink with our food. Bakit nga ba yung mga burger joint, laging may soft drink? Bakit hindi sila magtinda ng tsaa together with their burger? No, total, mamantika na rin lang naman yung burger eh. So, why not tea together with it? Okay. Now, what do we take instead of the soft drink or colored drinks? Again, for those who have gone to Taiwan, gone to Japan, these are the kind of drinks that they offer. Dapat siguro magaya na rin natin as Filipinos. Next slide, please. Yan. How do we clean our kidneys? Kinchai. Kinchai can be made into a drink. Another recipe, beetroot with cucumber. So these have been known to cleanse the kidney. Hindi lang kung may kidney stone ka, basta meron kang problema sa kidney, including urinary tract infection, these are very good juices that we can take. Now, I have been mentioning some supplements, some vitamins that would be good for those who suffer these diseases. Next slide will show us, ano yung maganda sa kidney? Niacin. It's a form of vitamin B3. Pinag-aralan din ito. Studies have shown that B3 may help slow down the phosphorus level na kalaban ng taong mataas ang creatinine with those with impaired renal function. The study suggests that B3 and its metabolites effectively decreases phosphorus absorption in the gut. So niacin is a good vitamin again. I'm down to my last few slides. Can we go to the next slide, please? This is common among the workforce, ang paghapdi ng sikmura. Okay, akala nila dahil nalipasan lang sila ng gutom, hindi nila alam, maaaring may mga wrong kind of bacteria in their digestive system. Next slide, please. Ito yung wrong kind. The bad bacteria, dahil sa puro karne ang kinakain natin, lalo na kung it is processed food, it overwhelms our digestive system, natatalo ang good bacteria. So, pwede tayong magkaroon ng gastric acidity. One of those bacteria is called H. pylori. Sikat na sikat yan. Yung H. pylori, kayang bumutas ng bituka niyan. Next slide, please. So, ito yung nararamdaman. Alam naman natin nararamdaman, paninikip ng sikmura. Minsan naduduwal tayo. Minsan akala natin, inatake na tayo sa puso. Hindi pala lahat dahil sa acidity. Next slide. It could also be due to, sa next slide po please, gallbladder problem. Yung pagkain natin ng mamantika, nagsisikrit tayo ng bile, punong-puno na ng bile ang ating gallbladder, tumitigas na yung bile na yon na dating buhangin, nagiging bato. And that can also cause acidity. So anong pwede natin gawin? No? Inumin. Next slide again, please. Wow! If we are going to choose between a synthetic iron that is normally prescribed by doctors, gaya ng ferrous sulfate, maasim sa sikmura yun. I-try natin ang pag-inom ng mga natural sources of iron. One of those would be chlorella. The other is spirulina. Marami po in the market with that. So, let's go to our next slide. Again, juice therapy will help doon sa ating nararamdaman sa sikmura. Another condition. Next slide, please. Karamihan sa mga babae, hindi na maikabit ang kanilang bra because they have frozen shoulder. Next slide. Karamihan sa mga lalaki, hindi makalakad ng mabuti when they wake up in the morning, pagtapak pa lang sa floor dahil masakit yung kanilang paa. These are deposits in our joints. So we must learn to say no to some of those that causes these deposits. Next slide, please. And these are the things that we should say no to. Combo number one, paborito ng mga workforce yan. Papasok sa isang fast food store, combo number one, combo number two, combo number three. Hindi nila napupuna, that's their meal every day for Monday to Friday. And then one day, they realize that they are already deficient in a lot of nutrients, but with a lot of toxins in their body. Next slide, please. So, sa next slide, ano ang pwede nating inumin again? Biochemical findings indicate functional problems with thiamine deficiency can help, no? Yung pag-inom ng thiamine can help those with deficiencies resulting in pain in their joints. So, kanina may B3, ito ngayon, B1. Aba, ganda, nakita nila 37% to 71% reduction in fatigue and up to 80% reduction in pain. So, instead of us masyadong dependent on pain relievers like mefenamic acid, some of our listeners probably are already taking celecoxib, wag po tayong masyadong dependent on those because they can damage kidneys. What do we do? Next slide, please. Cleansing. Kapag may nararamdaman tayo, ang una nating gawin, mag-cleansing. If you remember, I do not know if you remember, if you are old enough, no, sa mga listeners natin, may mga lola tayo who are doing enema in their children. Namana nila rin yun sa mga lola rin nila . Ang tawag nila ron, enema labatiba as cleansing. There is some wisdom to it. Hindi na natin gagawin ng enema probably now, but at least we can do some fluid cleansing, some detoxification, diet modification, as well as some form of fasting. Malaking tulong yon. Next slide, please. This is one of the therapies that we do in our clinic. It is controversial, but a lot of clinics in Europe, as well as in the USA, are doing it concomitant with the treatment of their doctors and other cardiologists. Okay? Hindi ito lang. Pantulong lang ito doon sa binibigay ng kanilang doktor. Next slide, please. Why? Kasi may mga tao na dependent na rin sa statins. Mataas ang cholesterol and triglyceride. 3 years nang umiinom ng statins. Remember my opening introduction na ang mga lolo natin are not taking so much medicine and yet they live long? Maybe because they know what to do. Hindi lang puro gamot ang solusyon. Next slide, please. Hindi natin nalalaman, but mababasa natin, and in fact, we can ask our doctors, even statins have side effects. Hindi pwedeng sabihin na ang gamot na ito ay walang side effect lamang. Because most medicines do have side effects. So we have to ask our doctors about those. Next slide, please. And what can we ask our doctor? Ito yan. A plant-based diet has been shown to reduce death by about 40%. Hindi mo naman kailangan maging vegetarian o maging vegan, pero siguraduhin mo lang na si tuwing kakain ka, mayroong gulay in 1/4 part of your plate. In 1/4 part of your plate. And all in all, down to my last 2 slide, huwag nating kalimutan, hindi po doktor ang nagpapagaling, hindi rin po gamot ang nagpapagaling. Sa totoo lang, instrumento lang tayo